Welcome to the master's talk. In this master's talk, I'm going to discuss about the domain, codomain and range. Generally, many of the students will be get confused what is codomain, what is the range. Because domain, generally, it will be clear. It is a set of values of independent variable. Range is a set of value of the independent variable. But what is the codomain? And what is the relation between codomain and range? It is little bit confusing, but no need to worry. I will make it very, very crystal clear. What is the domain? What is the codomain? And what is the range? And which condition range will be exactly equal to codomain? And which condition range will be a proper subset of codomain? And which condition range will be a subset of codomain? Then this is your part of algebra and graph. And of course, it is going to affect your quantitative ability preparation. Function is a relation. I told already, function is a relation. All the function must be a relation, but all the relation, it is not necessary, it will be a function. Means if it is a relation with certain condition, it will be a function. Other, if that relation is not, if that condition is not satisfied, that relation we can say it is a not function. Then two variables will be there that already I have discussed. I am again telling to you, this is your input or independent variable that is denoted by x. Another is output that is dependent variable that is denoted by y. Relation between y and x, if it is defined by certain mathematical formulas or mathematical relation, as a common we will tell it is a function, and we will denote by y equal to fx. This fx may be, it is related by a square, or it is related by a straight line, or it is related by a square root, or it is related by something other mathematical operations. Here we are not discussing which mathematical operations are working for this function. We are interested only this function, is this relation is a function or not, or if it is a function, then what is the domain, what is the codomain, and what is the range. Then here just we'll pick two sets, set A and set B. Here y equal to fx, this function is defined by 2x plus 1, or you can say it is defined by one of the straight line. If you are putting one input x, value of x, then certain output will come. Like x equal to 1, it will be 3, like this one. X equal to 1, it is coming 3. X equal to 2, it will be 5. And x equal to 3, it will be 7. And x equal to 4, it will be 9. Very sure, there is no problem. Two sets are there. Elements of sets of set A, that is called input, or you can say value of, or you can say value of x. This is your output, set B, or you can say it is a y. Just we'll look little bit deep, or little bit more observation. Set A, this is your input, that is your independent variable, that is called x. Value of x will be called domain. Here two type of questions sometimes will come. One is value of independent variable or dependent variable, and sometimes question will be there, number of elements in set A and set B, or you can say what is the number of elements and how many elements are in domain, how many elements are in range, how many elements are in codomain. Means one time maybe it is counting based, one time it may be value based. Then two type of question may be here generated. Then values of x, that will represented by domain, and that is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. That is called a domain. This is your domain. Very simple. From where it is a starting or input will be there, that set will called domain. Set B, that is your output, that is your y, that is your dependent variable. Now output can be two type. That is only you have to understand. Output can be two types. Whatever output has given in set B, that is actual or that is possible. If it is actual output, means what is defined based on this function, that is called range. This is your actual output. Apart from actual output, certain other elements are there that is not included in your actual output. Means you can say that is not an output of certain input or certain value of domain, then you can say it is a possible output. This future mein ho sakta hai. कोई और वैल्यू डोमेन में डालेंगे, then it can be a possible output. This is called codomain. Very simple. Like this set, range is 3, 5, 7, 9. Range is 3, 5, 7, 9 because 3 is your actual output if you are putting input 1. 5 is your another output if you are putting input 2. 7 is your another output if you are putting input 3. And 9 is another output if you are putting input 4. Then 3, 5, 7, 9, or you can say all odd numbers. That is your, based on here again, number properties question will come, or number, even number, or maybe related to some other perfect number or perfect cube number. Based on that also question will be there, based on the number properties. Here range is 3, 5, 7, 9 because y equal to 2x plus 1, that is representing nothing, it is representing an odd number. Odd number we are representing 2n plus 1. In place of 2n plus 1, in place of n, it is written x. That much only. But this will be always odd. This will be always odd. Means all the odd number will fall down in this range. All the odd number will fall down in this range. All the natural number will fall down in codomain. That is only difference. Means if we are taking the set of natural number 1 to 10, that we can say it is a codomain. That we can say it is a codomain. But exact output, actual output is only odd number 3, 5, 7, 9. Other than that, 2, 4, 6, 8 is not actual output. That is possible output. If we will change this function, then this output may be. You are getting my idea? Means we have taken the set B like natural number 1 to 10. Defined as per defined function, it is coming only odd number output. Then 3, 5, 7, 9 is your actual output, that is called range. Just to suppose, if you have changed this function, you have put y equal to 2x, then what will happen? Apart from this range, another value also will start to come, and that will fall down in range, correct? Then you can say in codomain, all the possible value, what can be, if you are changing the input or you are changing the relation, may be included. But range only will be included what is exactly you got based on the exact input, whatever given in your set A. That is only difference. Then this, based on this simple relation, we can say range will be always subset of codomain. This is notation of subset, nothing else. This is set theory. That related to that, again, 1.5 hour session is there. If you, once you will log into PadhoLeekho.com, separate session is there based on the set theories related to function. Lot of sessions are there. I think more than 8 to 10 session will be there. That is related to function, graph, transformation of graph, shifting of the graph. All sessions are there. If you want to go detail, you can just go for PadhoLeekho.com. Then here range will be a subset of codomain. That by seeing itself, you can say 3, 5, 7, 9 will be always subset of natural number 1 to 10, because between 1 to 10, 3, 5, 7, 9 is 4 odd number. Now, if you are just changing this question based on the counting, the number of elements in range will be always less and equal to the number of elements in codomain. Here, just we'll check, number of elements in range is how many? 4. Number of elements in codomain, it is 10. What is happening here? Number of elements in range will be always less than or equal to the number of elements in codomain. Here 4 will be 4 is less than 10. If range is exactly equal to codomain, when it will happen? When it will happen? If function is exactly 1 to 1 and surjective, then only one case will happen. It will be range will be exactly equal to codomain. In that case, number of elements in range will be equal to the number of elements in codomain. Other cases, it will be less than that. I kept this notation less and equal. Then variety of relations and functions are defined based on this one, and based on this contradiction, range is subset of codomain, what is codomain, or maybe some little confusion to understand the domain and codomain, variety of questions or variety of problems used to ask in all type of exams. Continue to learn at the rate of PadhoLeekho.com. Thank you.